Infinity War is partly based on the 2013 comic miniseries Infinity. Notice that the new Avengers logo used in this series is the Greek letters Alpha and Omega combined. Also, observe that on the cover of Volume 3, Issue 9, this logo is directly above Thanos and has a color scheme similar to his. This seems to imply that Thanos identifies with Alpha and Omega. In the book of Revelation, Jesus Christ declares that he is Alpha and Omega. So Infinity War's inspiration comes from a comic story arc that hints at Thanos being a Jesus archetype.
In time, you will know what it's like to lose. Dread it, run from it. The end is near.
In one of the 2018 trailers for Infinity War, Thanos states, "The end is near." This is a common belief in Christian theology.
Hear me and rejoice. You have had the privilege of being saved by the great Titan. You may think this is suffering. No, it is salvation. Universal scales tip toward balance because of your sacrifice. Smile, for even in death, you have become children of Thanos.
The movie starts with Ebony Maw, one of the children of Thanos, given a sermon about being saved by Thanos through sacrifice and death. The idea of someone dying as a sacrifice for salvation is taken directly from the story of Jesus. Wow, less than 2 minutes into the movie and we're already getting strong messianic overtones. 20 saves.
Hear me and rejoice. You have had the privilege of being saved by the great Titan.
Ebony Maw opens his sermon with telling the slaughtered Asgardians to rejoice in being saved by Thanos. In the Gospels, Jesus constantly told his disciples to rejoice in the salvation he brought.
Hear me and rejoice. You are about to die at the hands of the children of Thanos. Be thankful that your meaningless lives are now contributing to the balance.
I'm sorry, Earth is closed today.
Ebony Maw serves as a messenger of Thanos, preaching his ideologies and majesty to entire planets. According to the New Testament, the messengers of Jesus preached his ideologies and majesty to the whole world.
There are two more stones on Earth. Find them, my children, and bring them to me on Titan.
Father, we will not fail you.
The four children of Thanos you see at the beginning of the movie are not his actual progeny. They're more like his disciples or servants. So when Ebony Maw told the slaughtered Asgardians, "For even in death you have become children of Thanos," he was saying that they had converted over to being servants of Thanos. In the New Testament, the disciples of Jesus refer to converts as children of God.
Destiny arrives all the same. And now it's here. Or should I say, I am.
While talking to Loki, Thanos declares, "I am," a title ascribed only to God and Jesus in the Bible. And if you think this is a stretch, in the previous Avengers movie, Age of Ultron, Vision declared the phrase when asked who he is.
You think I'm a child of Ultron?
You're not?
I'm not Ultron. I'm not Jarvis. I am.
Almighty Thanos, I, Loki, do hereby pledge to you my undying fidelity.
Undying.
You should choose your words more carefully.
Loki was once a loyal servant of Thanos, but eventually betrays him. So even the Mad Titan has his Judas.
Thanos is coming. He's coming.
After Bruce is transported to Earth, the first thing he says is, "Thanos is coming," meaning coming to invade Earth. This is an allusion to the second coming of Jesus, which, believe it or not, is described exactly as an alien invasion.
Tell me his name again.
Thanos. He's a plague, Tony. He invades planets. He takes what he wants. He wipes out half the population. He sent Loki. The attack on New York. That's him.
This is it. What's our timeline?
No telling.
When Tony asked Bruce how long they had until Thanos arrived, Bruce replied, no telling, meaning no one knows. The New Testament states that no one knows when Jesus is coming.
What's wrong, little one?
My mother. Where is my mother?
What's your name?
Gamora.
You're quite the fighter, Gamora. Come, let me help you.
When Gamora was a child, Thanos' army mercilessly massacred half the population of her home planet. Thanos, however, showed Gamora compassion, indicating that he has a soft spot for children. In the Gospels, we read that Jesus was especially tender-hearted towards children.
What's wrong, little one?
My mother. Where is my mother?
You knew I'd come.
I counted on it. There's something we need to discuss, little one.
Because you murdered half the planet.
A small price to pay for salvation.
You're insane.
Little one, it's a simple calculus. I'm sorry, little one.
Thanos intimately refers to Gamora as little one, a phrase Jesus often used for the children he cherished. Thanos' army bears a striking resemblance to the Roman soldiers of old, who had a strong presence in Israel during the time of Jesus. Notice that the people on Gamora's home planet who are killed are to the left of Thanos, while those who are spared are on his right. In his parable of the sheep and goats, Jesus declared that he would place the righteous who inherit the kingdom on his right, while those condemned to hell will be placed on his left.
Your planet was on the brink of collapse. I'm the one who stopped that. Do you know what's happened since then? The children born have known nothing with full bellies and clear skies, it's a paradise.
Because you murdered half the planet.
A small price to pay for salvation.
You're insane.
Titan was like most planets. Too many mouths, not enough to go around. And when we faced extinction, I offered a solution.
Genocide.
But random, dispassionate, fair to rich and poor alike. They called me a madman.
Gamora and Thanos' own people called him insane because of his radical beliefs, hence the nickname the Mad Titan. Many of Jesus' critics felt his beliefs were radical and said he was crazy.
How is it you know this place so well?
A lifetime ago, I too sought the stones. I even held one in my hand. But it cast me out, banished me here.
After arriving on Vorbir, Thanos and Gamora climb a mountain. They then meet Red Skull, the villain in the first Captain America movie, who ascended to this planet a lifetime ago without dying. In the Gospels, Jesus leads three of his disciples up a mountain. There, they see apparitions of Moses and Elijah, the latter of whom ascended to heaven centuries earlier without dying. After after Gamora is sacrificed, the clouds above the mountain light up with a bright flash. A bright cloud overshadowed Jesus and his disciples when they were on the mountain. We then see a close-up shot of the pain expression on Thanos' face, which for a split second is illuminated by the bright light above. When Jesus is transfigured on the mountain, his face momentarily shines as bright as the sun. Thanos sacrificed his beloved daughter Gamora to obtain the Soul Stone and ultimately to save the universe. Now, where do you suppose they got the idea of a godlike figure sacrificing his beloved child to save countless souls? I don't know, does John 3:16 come to mind? After Thanos sacrifices Gamora, he suddenly wakes up in what appears to be a river. Was this some kind of baptism, something Jesus underwent?
All right, let me ask you this one time. What master do you serve? What master do I serve? What am I supposed to say, Jesus?
Yes.
Titan was like most planets. Too many mouths, not enough to go around. And when we faced extinction, I offered a solution.
Genocide.
But random, dispassionate, fair to rich and poor alike. They called me a madman. And what I predicted came to pass.
Congratulations, you're a prophet.
I'm a survivor.
Thanos correctly predicted that his people would become extinct due to starvation. Jesus correctly predicted that many of his people would die of starvation during the destruction of Jerusalem.
With all six stones, I could simply snap my fingers. They would all cease to exist, and I call that mercy.
Thanos, in his warped mind, believes that instantly ending the existence of trillions is an act of mercy. In the Gospels, Jesus stressed the importance of being merciful in his teachings. When Tony and the others manage to bind up Thanos, Thanos' arms are eagle spread as if he were being crucified.
Tell me you didn't do it!
No, you didn't. No, you didn't.
Peter Quill, aka Star-Lord, refuses to believe Thanos when Thanos tells him that he had to kill Gamora. In the Gospels, the Apostle Peter refuses to believe Jesus when Jesus tells his disciples that he himself would have to be killed.
Stark.
You know me?
I do. You're not the only one cursed with knowledge.
My only curse is you.
Tony tells Thanos, my only curse is you. This means that Tony considered Thanos to be a curse. The Apostle Paul said that Jesus became a curse for us. Thanos uses the Time Stone to bring Vision back from the dead. So in a way, Thanos resurrected Vision. The Gospels record multiple cases of Jesus resurrecting people from the dead. After the infamous snap, Thanos momentarily journeys to the Soul World where he walks on water. This is an obvious reference to Jesus walking on water in the Gospels. Fun fact, Thanos was originally supposed to walk on a river of blood, representing the blood of the victims who were killed as a result of the snap. This scene, however, was altered because it was considered too dark. Revelation 19 and 15 speaks of Jesus treading or walking on the winepress, which represents the blood of the nations who are killed by him at his second coming. After Thanos snaps his fingers, half the people in the universe instantly die at random. This concept seems to have been borrowed from the remaining, a 2014 Christian apocalyptic movie. In this movie, millions worldwide die instantly of some random unknown cause. Check out how this scene perfectly meshes with Thanos' snap scene.
You should have gone for the head.
Video footage has been streaming in on a worldwide mysterious illness that strikes without warning and has caused millions of fatalities in the past hour.
Oh my God.
Leading experts from around the globe have been unable to determine the cause of what is being labeled instant death syndrome.
Oh, no!
You okay, Max? Yeah. Are you guys okay?
This is no place to die.
No, no, no. Groot. No.
Out of the ground, we were taken for the dust we are, and to the dust we shall return.
When Thanos travels using the space stone, the effect looks like a dark cloud. The New Testament states that Jesus will return on a cloud. After Thanos completes his mission, he leaves Earth and returns to his own planet to sit down. After Jesus completed his mission, he left Earth and ascended to heaven to sit down on the right hand of God.
So climb, we'll meet him in. They okay?
There's no one here.
Control. Code red.
The post-credits scene looks like something straight out of Left Behind, a movie centered around the rapture, an event in Christian eschatology associated with the coming of Jesus.
Hi, Mom. It's me. I just want to apologize for missing the party this afternoon. Oh, no. Are you okay?
Driver, there's no driver.